dimensional analysis, unit conversions, and how science saves a stranded astronaut from Mars. ...140 million miles from home. Stranded. Mark Watney is left for dead by NASA on Mars with no way to get home. All alone, with Earth thinking that he is dead and having no way to communicate to tell them otherwise. He needs to do some serious science to survive 4 years until the next Mars mission, Ares 4, arrives. In this video, we'll go through 13 dimensional analysis calculations that save Mark's life. The first problem Mark faces is figuring out how long he can survive with his current supplies. With supplies prepared for 6 people and a mission that had 50 souls left, 6 multiplied by 50 gives us 300 souls of food left for Watney to eat, 400 souls if he rations his food. In this video, we'll be using the term soul, since that is one day on Mars. 400 souls of rations will not allow Mark to survive 4 years, though. He needs another food source. He does, however, have some potatoes he can plant and grow more potatoes, and for that, he'll need to turn the hab into a greenhouse. If he covers the 92-meter-squared floor of the hab with 10 centimeters of soil, he will need 9.2 cubic meters of soil. Since Mark is a botanist, he knows that every cubic meter of soil needs 40 liters of water. With this unit conversion, he multiplies 9.2 times 40 to give 368 liters of water needed to convert all of the hab into a greenhouse. Notice in conversion grids, you need a unit on top to cancel with a unit on bottom. At the moment, however, Watney has only 250 liters of water to spare. How much soil can he hydrate with that amount? Again, we'll use 40 liters of water for every cubic meter of soil. This conversion is the reverse of the last conversion problem. Notice that as long as units on the top and on the bottom cancel, you can go whichever direction you need to with a conversion grid. 250 divided by 40 gives us 62.5 cubic meters of the hab that can be cultivated for potatoes. With the 62.5 cubic meters for farming, Mark estimates he can grow 150 kilograms of potatoes in the 400 souls he has. How much time does he need to extend his life? Well, each kilogram of potato gives us 770 calories, and a ration diet would need 1,500 calories every soul. 150 times 770 divided by 1,500 gives us 76 souls. Any numbers on the top of the grid we multiply, and any numbers on the bottom of the grid we divide. We can ignore the number 1. Extending Mark's demise by only 76 souls, though, won't get him to his target of 4 years. He needs to do some more problem solving. Mark decides to look at his problem a different way and calculates how many calories he will need to grow on average per soul. If he is to survive 1,425 souls, and he only has supplies for 400 souls, then he needs 1,025 souls worth of calories. A ration diet would require 1,500 calories, so we place one soul on the bottom of the grid so that the unit soul cancels on the top and on bottom. When we multiply 1,025 times 1,500, we get 1,537,500 calories that Mark will need to produce. How many calories per day is that? Let's divide our calories by the number of souls left, 1,425, and we get a good target goal for production, 1,100 calories per soul. Next problem. To cultivate the full hab, you'll need 6.4 cubic meters of soil. That's doable, just a few hours of back-breaking work to fix that. The issue lies in getting enough water for that soil. Remember, every cubic meter of soil needs 40 liters. So that will require 260 liters of water, water that Watney does not have. So where to get water on a planet with no water? Fortunately, the equation to produce water is simple, one oxygen molecule and two hydrogen molecules. One catch though, this reaction requires combustion. And how would NASA feel about Mark lighting flammable gases on fire in the hab? In the words of Mark Watney, they'd probably hide under their desks and cuddle with their slide rules for comfort. For now, let's focus on the oxygen needed. Mars has plenty of oxygen atoms in the atmosphere in the form of carbon dioxide. So with an oxygenator that Mark already has, he'll be set. Mark estimates he'll need 125 liters of oxygen, so how many sols will it take to collect the oxygen needed? Okay, start with a given, that is 125 liters of oxygen. In the next step, Mark thinks that 1 liter of carbon dioxide will produce 1 liter of oxygen. Yeah, that's not very likely. That would have been true if it was gaseous molecules, but he's talking about liquids, and stoichiometry doesn't work that way for liquids. Well, let's just continue on and hope he doesn't kill himself. Next part needed is how quickly carbon dioxide is pulled from the air. The current rate is 0.5 liters of carbon dioxide every hour. So if you check which units have already canceled in our unit conversion, we are at how many hours it takes to produce the oxygen. One more step to get to sols. On Mars, there are 24.65 hours in one sol. Multiply any numbers on top and divide any numbers on the bottom of the grid, and we get 10.1 sols to make the oxygen needed. Okay, let's fast forward a little. Despite blowing himself up a little in the process of making water, Watney's dimensional analysis calculations allows him to create the potato farm he needs to survive. The next problem he tackles is being able to communicate with NASA. In his usual resourceful way, Watney realizes that the Pathfinder probe is within driving range, a probe that probably still has functional communication. So time to do some science and figure out how to get his rover to travel the distance he needs. One of the major requirements of a large trip is a way to recharge his batteries on the rover. His batteries need 18,000 watt hours to fully recharge. Watney estimates that he can fully charge the batteries with 13 hours every sol. Lastly, the power rating of the solar panels he has is 500 watts produced every square meter. So 18,000 divided by 13 divided by 500 gives us 2.8 square meters. One caveat though, with Mars being farther from the Sun, the panels are only 10% efficient. So he'll need more than 2.8 square meters. He'll need 28 square meters of solar panels for his journey. One thing Mark also needs to deal with on his trip to the Pathfinder is carbon dioxide. He has all the oxygen he needs, but after breathing, carbon dioxide will build up, so he'll be using some of his carbon dioxide filters he has stored up. Looking at his supplies, he counts 2,089 hours worth of filters left. Given again that there are 24.65 hours in one sol, he has enough filters to last him 84.75 sols without the atmospheric regulator. Plenty. Thanks to some successful unit conversions, Mark is now communicating with NASA. All seems to go according to plan until Mars does everything in its power to try to kill Watney. After nearly blowing himself up again and losing his whole crop of potatoes, and NASA blowing up the last possible probe that could get him enough food to survive, NASA has one less Hail Mary to try and save him, but it requires two things. First, his old crewmates on the Hermes must turn around to come and pick him up, and secondly, for him to drive 3,200 kilometers to the Ares 4 launch site a lot sooner than they were planning on before. But before he goes, Watney needs to make some major renovations to the rover to be able to bring all the things he needs to survive. First major task, drill a big hole in the top of the rover. That can't be that bad, right? Well, unfortunately, the drill Mark uses was meant for Martian rocks, not for construction. To drill one hole, it takes 2 minutes and 40 seconds. Let's do the math and find out how many hours it will take to drill his hole. We start with 760 holes. For every hole, it takes 2 minutes and 40 seconds. But let's put that strictly in seconds. So that's 160 seconds. 60 seconds equals 1 minute, and 60 minutes equals 1 hour. Let's check to make sure all the necessary units cancel, leaving us with only hours at the end. Perfect. Okay, multiply the top numbers in the grid and divide the bottom numbers, and we get 34 hours of drilling required. Yikes. Looks like Mark has his work cut out for him. After getting his rover all set, Mark needs to calculate if his water supply will last on his trip. He has 620 liters of water, and his daily need for water is 3 liters every sol. That gives us 206 sols worth of water left over. Considering he has only 100 sols left on Mars, that will be plenty. Okay, time to make the long journey from the HAB to the Ares 4 launch site. The distance there is 3,200 kilometers. The souped-up rover can travel up to 90 kilometers every sol with ideal conditions. Looking at our grid, do we multiply or divide by 90 kilometers? We divide. So it will take a minimum of 35 sols for Watney to travel to the launch site. Thanks to many dimensional analysis calculations, the long journey to the launch site is successful. In order to reach a required relative velocity with Hermes, Mark makes a number of alterations to the Mars Ascent Vehicle. After this, he launches into orbit to meet up with the Hermes crew. Unfortunately, the launch has complications and the MAV's trajectory is off. As a result, the Hermes crew needs to find a way to slow their ship way down. What better way than to make a bomb and create some propulsion in the opposite direction? Things never go wrong with bombs on spaceships, right? Well, thanks to Vogel, knowing some serious chemistry, he knows how to use sugar to make a bomb. How much energy can 1 kilogram of sugar give you? If we had 1 kilogram of sugar, and knowing that 1 kilogram of sugar produces 400 calories, and 1 calorie is equal to 4,184 joules, a 1 kilogram sugar bomb that proceeds to full reaction would give us 16.7 million joules of energy, or about as much as 8 sticks of dynamite. Okay, the hatch is blown, relative velocities line up, Mark pulls an Iron Man to fly his way back to his crewmates, and the whole world celebrates what Watney and NASA have achieved in the past 564 days, or 549 sols if you did the conversion. All thanks to unit conversions, dimensional analysis, and the sheer determination of an astronaut to do the science and beat the odds.
That's all it is. You just begin. You do the math. You solve one problem, then you solve the next one, and then the next. And if you solve enough problems, you get to come home.